So let me talk to you about the five most severe types of property claims that are likely to happen to you in a mental health, substance use disorder, or service provider environment for the intellectually and developmentally disabled. First, fires. It's cooking fires, kitchen fires, electrical fires, somebody smoking in the building. Two, employee dishonesty. This happens when you don't have great financial controls over the people that use the money in the organization. The really sad part about employee dishonesty is it happens over a long period of time. And the most tragic stories that you read are people that had financial control for 20 years and were embezzling a little bit of money over a long period of time. Can add up to some really big dollars. Three is burglary. Cash on hand, somebody breaking in and stealing the money. Four, collapse. So if you've got a building and you're not doing a great job keeping the roof up to date, there's a lot of weight of ice and snow on the roof, there's a collapse, that's going to be a big claim. There's no way around that being big dollars being paid out. And five, biohazard cleanup. Once again, we're dealing with people. And when you clean up blood, when you clean up bodily fluids, you have to get a very specialized type of contractor in there that puts on the white hazmat suits and gets things cleaned up. There's no way to do that cheap. So what are some things that you can do about it, you can do to prevent these types of situations? One, have a fire protection program. Once again, keep in mind that the three most common ways that you're gonna have a fire in a residential environment are that you're gonna have a cooking issue, you're gonna have somebody smoking in the building, or it's gonna be electrical. So if you can keep your facilities up to date and tell people not to smoke near the building, you're gonna nip a lot of these things in the bud. For employee dishonesty, you gotta have strong financial controls. Work with your CPA, whoever's auditing you. Make sure that you are implementing what they are telling you to do. It's really about segregation of duties. You don't want somebody that can collect the money to be able to reconcile the statements and then report it to the board with no oversight. That's how you have big problems. So if any of this is making you think about your insurance program and broker relationship, and you'd like to talk to somebody with experience in your field, request a quote at www.bitnerhenry.com. I'm Daryl Henry with Bitner Henry Insurance Group, and we serve those who serve others.